Hey guys, it's Gary here. Some of you online will know me as smartbluecat. This is really a video introducing my next project. A few of you have sent me messages asking me what I'm up to, I guess also prompted by my YouTube background graphic, which contains images from the project, wanting to know what the models are, if there's a story, that kind of thing. So I hope to answer a few of those questions here. The project is a 25-minute long CGI animated horror story called Open the Door. It's not horror in the mold of Hills Have Eyes or Texas Chainsaw Massacre or anything like that. It's got a kind of grim fairy tale aspect to it. The theme of it is love versus fear, and the premise is a boy and his mom trapped in a house with a creature who lives off of fear. The story of Open the Door really comes from my want to express something emotionally engaging. I try and do that with everything that I do artistically, but to really have that at the forefront of my mind while creating this project and to really have it there throughout the whole process and build this particular piece on those themes is something that I've wanted to do for a long time. Having this story about a mother and a son, it means that I don't have to spend a lot of time on exposition explaining why they love each other or care about each other. I can just get to the meat and gravy of showing you their relationship in a much more casual, less forced way. But anyway, this project's really, really tough for me. When I try and think about everything that I need to do for this project, I just get the biggest headache. And there's so much stuff here that I'm not comfortable with. Painting weights and rigging right now is my current nightmare. Stuff I've never done on humans before. I've kind of been teaching myself this stuff for a few years. And this is, by a long shot, the hardest thing I've ever done. I'm not an expert at any of this. I'm just really making it up as I'm going along, as I'm sure a lot of you can tell. I think a lot of this is about not quitting until I see something I like on the screen. It's very easy to say that'll do when it could be done better. Right, so the world of Open the Door, although it's animated, is not cartoony. Even though the characters themselves are quite toon-like, they're very simple and stuff. The environments, the world that they inhabit, I want it to be quite tangible. And also for the emotional impact, I need it to be relatively grounded. I don't want it to be too overbearing, but certainly dark, and hopefully beautiful. That's the aesthetic that I'm going for. In this world, there are consequences. These characters, they can bleed and they can cry, and hopefully they can also express love in a realistic way, almost in a flippant way. The way it often occurs between people who are at home with caring deeply for each other is something that's understated, and that's what makes it kind of real, and that's what I'm aiming for. This is, without a doubt, quite a tall order for someone like me who's never really even done any human character animation before, but I'll give it my best shot. Yeah, so, like I said, this project is vast. When I try and consider all the aspects that I'm going to need to go through and pull together and whatever to make this happen, it's terrifying. Everything needs to be built from scratch. All the characters designed, all the furniture designed, all the props, you know, all that kind of stuff needs to be built and thought about and considered and textured and rigged and all that kind of stuff. And I need to learn how to do human character animation, which is something I better get good at quickly because I've got no experience in it whatsoever. And this is an incredibly character-heavy piece. The only project that I've done that is close to this in terms of scale, the only thing I've done that's I could hold up to this to give myself an idea of what it might be like is Robotify, which some of you might have seen on my YouTube channel. And that was heavy going. That was about 2 months of prep and then 4 months of animating and rendering. I like to render as I go. And a frame of Robotify would take anywhere over 7 minutes to render. But that's before going into post and adding particle effects or whatever, or, you know, grading or whatever. And each of those frames was about between 6 and 9 meg. It takes up a lot of space. I've had to get more hard drive space for Open the Door, because going by Robotterfly takes up the original TGA perfect quality sequence is over 50 gig sitting on my hard drive. So Open the Door is like over five times the size, or about five times the size. So that has to all be taken care of as well. But like I say, everything needs to be built. Everything needs to be taken care of from scratch. So where I'm sitting at right now is all the characters' heads have been built, and I'm working on the bodies right now, rigging and painting weights and inserting animation controls and all that kind of stuff. A lot of the props have been built. Parts of the intro have been actually rendered and composited. Some of the stuff you can see on the screen right now is from those sequences. These aren't by any means locked off. They might stay the same, they might not. I'm quite happy with the way the look of the film is going right now. But yeah, it's huge, and it's terrifying. Terrifying is the key word here for me. It's pushing boundaries massively. There's certainly a level of uncertainty going into a project this size. You don't know what you're capable of. So I'm just going to set the bar really high and hope for the best. The script's been written, and a lot of the acting has been recorded. And I'm almost at the stage where I can listen to it as a radio play, which is very cool because I get an idea of how the film's going to flow. I can close my eyes and imagine it playing out in front of me. And, you know, that certainly helps me thinking about ideas for shots and where I'm going to put the camera and stuff, just hearing it happen. A friend of mine has lent me his nice condenser mic, so I'll be using that to record the Foley, the sound effects. And I'll be layering that in with the music at the very end. That'll be the final stage. This is going to be the first of a few videos, hopefully, on Open the Door, because it's the biggest thing I've ever done. I want to try and document it. So if you guys are interested, there'll be more. Okay, this is now officially my longest ever video, so I'm going to try and wrap it up before you guys get too bored, if you aren't too bored already. Before I go, I want to say a big thanks to everybody who's supported me and stuff online. I was astounded at the positive response I got when I started to upload my work. I don't know when anyone else who does this. I've been learning digital art in a bubble. Yeah, it was terrifying putting my stuff up online for the first time. I thought I was going to be shouted down and lots of nasty comments. That just hasn't been the case. I've been very lucky that it's found such a lovely audience. So thank you very, very much, all those people that leave kind comments and have subscribed to my videos and stuff online. It means a lot to me, so thank you very much. Also, this project doesn't mean I'm going to stop posting other work online. I'm going to take time out from Open the Door occasionally because I'll probably need a break, and I'll choose another song that I've written and I'll make a video for it, or I'll do some little thing, I don't know, just to take a break. But yeah, this is the main thing I'll be working on. So hopefully you can expect some more of these videos, probably shorter than this one. They might be just little glorified slideshows showing you how sets are coming together or whatever. I'm afraid I'm not going to tell you everything about Open the Door in these videos, certain elements of the story and the characters. I want to be a surprise to you when you watch the film, but a lot of the process will certainly be documented here. Unless my laptop gives out, which is a possibility, anything can happen over 2 years. But yeah, thank you very much for listening to this for so long. I hope you haven't been too bored. Take care, guys. Cheers.